most people, black and white, do not want to talk about race. That's just the reality. For me, it's always a time and place to talk about race. For some people, there's never a time to talk about race. My anti-racism involvement was simply an automatic response to the circumstances in which I found myself. All of my family may have been as disturbed by the circumstances and the racism as I was, but they didn't all respond to it in the same way. It's not something which you can even particularly analyze. It's simply, this is what you're prompted to do, or a way in which to react.
I think Dr. Hodgson's way of doing everything was always from a place of truth. If you needed to know the truth, she's a teacher by profession, that's what she was trained, she will tell you what the truth is.
She's very incisive in the way in which she presents her case. You can't argue with her at the end of the day. Even her enemies, they talk about her as a person, and they talk about her obsession with race and so forth, but they never deal with her arguments.
Dr. Hodgson has always been someone who has access to examine what's happening. She was writing letters to the editor then, and that was in the 60s. That was, writing letters to the editor wasn't necessarily about just telling you what's wrong, but it was about looking at what it is that we're doing in the local context so that we can examine it beyond just the cursory look that maybe we're doing it.
I don't think about what the reaction's going to be when I'm saying or writing, simply because I'm sufficiently intense about the circumstances that my need to express my reaction to it is far stronger than any fears that might or might not be there or should be there. Just as an artist takes up a paintbrush and needs to paint because that's the way they express themselves, I take up a pen and write what I'm thinking or what's going on in my mind.
When I first met her, to really have those deep conversations was probably 2006, 2007. And what struck me was that she just came from such a place of authority and knowledge about what she was talking about. And she really understood so many things that I hadn't even given any time to. And she was an amazing mentor. And I began to realize a lot of the information I'd gleaned from various other things, how wrong so much of that was, and that she took the time and had the patience to mentor me through this process.
My family influenced me. I think my father's family, who all of whom were Christian, were the greater influence, I would say, rather than my mother's family. And the two things which I would emphasize is, as I said, commitment to education and the commitment to spiritual life, to being Christian. The Christian thought at the moment, many other social activities were considered worldly. And we weren't supposed to be involved in worldly activities. So that the church was the center of our social life.
Education has always been very important in the black community. It's also been very important in the Christian community. So both of those things coming together in my family probably accounts for it. We all went to school, we all got scholarships and aimed to get the most out of education that we could.
Dr. Hodgson has a number of degrees from prestigious universities, undergraduate, graduate master's degrees, as well as a doctorate from Columbia University. You can't get much better than that. And at a time when not so many people had those kind of level of degrees at that time back, black people, I should say, in those days. And yet she never had a position in this country commensurate with that type of education. And much of it was because she was a voice for the oppressed. She was a voice against the injustice, a voice against the racial prejudice that was exhibited daily in Bermuda. And so she was sidelined, marginalized substantially from any possibility of employment.
I know as a member of her family that we as a family have always been very proud of Dr. Hodgson and what she's done in terms of her academic qualifications. It's always offered us as a family a sense of pride in this woman who's been able to do this for Bermuda. And it's always been for Bermuda because that's how she is.
Well, I have been criticized by both blacks and whites, but I think it's inevitable that if you express strong opinions, you're going to have people who are going to disagree with you.
Anybody who speaks out anywhere, not just Bermuda, but anywhere, if you question the status quo, you pay a price. And we probably don't even know the extent to which people pay a price. I think once you choose to say, stop, let's think a minute, you're going to pay a price.
I suppose the worst criticism that I have a problem with it only because it's not true, and that is that I hate white people. I think that they have found it to their advantage to have a society which places them at an advantage, and they've benefited from it, and they haven't attempted to change it. I'm sure that there have been times when I've criticized blacks for one thing or another, either because they were participating in white injustice or accepting it for their personal benefit, or because they were not being sufficiently proactive in protesting or resisting racial injustice. And there's no question that I probably criticized any of them.
I think the persistence and the resolution that she has as part of her character to keep at this for so many years. I mean, we're talking 75 plus years that she's been doing this work, almost 80 years, because she was a teenager when she first began to do this kind of work and start to be outspoken about the racism that she witnessed. She's talking about all sorts of things that were relevant, but at the time, people did not want to hear those messages that she was giving.
We all thought that she should take a break and be more concerned with her own personal well-being. But we were all so supportive because, again, it goes back to the rationale. We knew that what she was saying and doing was right. And you can't tell somebody too openly, don't do what's right. She always argued that it was the psychological factor. I've come to the conclusion that she's right and I'm wrong.
For me to talk about race, to bring it up, automatically means that I'm being negative. If you talk about it, it's an issue with blacks and whites. You know, don't talk about it. It's a negative to bring it up. If there's a time or a place, I guess the time and place is when a person runs into the experience.
Hearts and minds have changed because of her. I think both in the black community and in the white community, they may not always have agreed with what she's done or how she's gone about it, but they understand that voice now, the voice that they used to historically demean or marginalize, they understand more now today that what she was doing was extraordinary and over the years, and that she persistently stuck with it.
As a country as small as Bermuda is, to have Dr. Hodgson as one of our citizens who has done as much in terms of her academic work, her willingness to do the best that she can for her home. I think we should, as Bermudians, be very proud. She's definitely had to struggle, and we can be very proud of her work in the area and her willingness to work in spite of having had maybe taunts and all of that kind of stuff thrown at her. No matter what was thrown at her, she's still been able to say, I do this work because it is the right thing to do.
I don't know that history teaches us anything. Knowledge is always useful. It's useful to look at our history, but whether it makes any difference to us after we're looked at it, I don't know that it does. I think as flawed human beings that we go on making the same mistakes. Each generation has to fight for its own freedom, if you like. Freedom is not free.